I'm so dedicated to my destination. I'ma get it how I live it with no hesitation. See me making moves and all this training proves that I'm possible.
All I want to see right now is your ability to drive to the basket, toss the tennis ball up to yourself, go get it, get your finish. All right, but I want you to start to think about this. In the game of basketball, when I finish a basket, what are the different experiences, sensations, emotions, and feelings that I'm going to experience? I'm going to experience anxiety. I'm going to experience distractions. I'm going to experience delays. Because someone holds me, I have to delay through it. I'm going to experience just overall timing issues, jumping issues, space issues. But what happens to a lot of you when you drive to the basket and you're experiencing all that, you'll start stuttering your feet. You'll start trying to time everything, right? And so how do we work on that? By working on what's happening here. For self-grab finishing, we're gonna use our small medicine ball. Now this is 2 pounds. Now you could use a tennis ball, you can use different things. I like the medicine ball because it's soft, and if I miss it, and if it falls out of my hands, it's not gonna bounce away. So it keeps me in a very efficient environment that's not gonna be messy and sloppy and waste time. But the reason why I like self-grab finishes is number one, I can simulate things when I'm by myself. Number two is it actually requires a different level of poise and coordination to actually throw it to myself without losing my comfort level on the dribble. So what I want you to picture on this is you're gonna drive to the basket. How you choose to drive is up to you. But when I'm driving to the basket, I wanna give myself my own toss. So I'm gonna toss the ball in the air. I can put some height on it, no matter how I wanna jump. But then when I jump, I wanna be able to make contact with my hand and locate it. Now there's a couple things that can represent. Obviously, this can represent contact and my ability to use my hand in the air. But if I want to take it past just a defender, because a lot of times we're doing these things not to simulate defense, but to simulate characteristics and qualities, what it really does at a higher level is it forces my eyes to go to somewhere before they go to the basket. Because a lot of times as a player, our eyes can get so fixated on the backboard and on the rim that it actually becomes unrealistic. There's no distractions. And so it's easy to make a finish when I can just focus on my target the entire time. The reality is the game requires us to make very quick adjustments with our eyes and with our body. This causes us to do both. So if I have to locate the ball with my eyes and my hand, then focus on my finish, it really starts to bring in a lot of those game characteristics and qualities and the sensations that happen during the game. But here's what I don't want you to do. I don't want you to say the old cliche, make practice hard so the game is easy. It's too easy to do that. We're not only doing this to make something harder. If that was the case, we'd put everybody in sumo suits, those big giant suits, we'd fill your shoes with concrete, and we'd do all kinds of crazy stuff just to make things harder. So that's not our focus. What we are doing is adding game distractions. Because when distractions happen, our body's gotta continue to be able to operate normally. So literally all I want you to do during your self-grab finishes is drive, toss, grab, and finish without it causing your body to change. Now here's what's gonna happen. When you do this by yourself, you're gonna have a tendency to wanna judge your steps. So you'll start to stutter your feet to try to time it. We don't wanna have any type of inauthentic movements right now. We just wanna drive. So I wanna show you slow really quick. If I was driving and I toss it and I'm jumping to finish, nothing changed in my rhythm. My feet never changed. I was able to toss, I'm able to adjust to it, and I'm able to still find my finish. If anything becomes abnormal, that means you need to continue working on this. It doesn't mean that you're doing something wrong. It means that your body is being challenged by the multitasking, the poise that it's being asked of, and really your overall coordination. So there's a lot here. This is the type of series that can be really messy, really sloppy, really nasty, and you need to stay with it. And as long as you do, especially if you've done this 3 times, you're gonna start noticing big things when it comes to your finishing.